Time we all got together, we went for a hike.
Glenwood Ave.
Several occasions, so thank you, Bob, for all the information you gave us. And it was requested by, it was Kim, who said, probably for her, to gather information on the lot on Rollins Road that's for sale, corner of Rollins and Peas and Summersworth Lane there. And for the life of me, I could not remember, because I didn't have anything in front of me. But as you can see, the lot is 129.9, and it's 3.89 acres, and it is still active. There's no contract on it, so.
Which one is this then?
This is that large lot on Rollins Road.
On Rollins Road.
So there's Peas Lane on one side.
Yeah, the second one that you guys.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I need to go look at that, but, okay.
It's right out by the road, it's not the one.
You've got the cow pasture, that.
Right, yeah, one of the woods was down on the road.
Rollins, some have their cows there, so.
Oh, okay.
But it's been for sale for a while, so, yeah.
Well, I know I didn't go to the other two lots, but is there a reason why we want to buy land versus Silver Street?
I think we're just options.
Yeah, there hadn't been.
Well, you talked about the other one too, right? No, we own the other one.
We own Silver Street, so.
Oh, you own Turcotte Field?
We own Turcotte Field, but I think the unanimous opinion, actually, by the time we left was that this probably wasn't suitable.
Turcotte, oh, yeah, that is.
I mean, that would be my vote if it came to that.
I mean, even folks that thought, oh, this might be a great idea, once we got out this dollars, a lot further out there than they thought.
But, you know.
But there was still some interest in this lot, so I said I would gather the information. We also have a tax card in front of you that shows the assessed value at this point, 115.6. It shows that's 3.85. Let's go with the tax card being correct versus the listing, but. I don't know if there's still interest in this lot, but if there is, we can certainly let the select board know if there is any select options.
Did we get our survey results? Did you get the survey results, Bob?
Oh, yeah.
It's been authorized, it's been authorized by the select board.
No, the survey of the residents in the area.
Oh, yeah, I forgot to bring those up, yes, I did.
Sorry.
I bring those up, I'm sorry.
Okay.
I'll get those right now. In reference to this piece of property here, there is a section over near the corner of Peas Lane and Rollins Road that's extremely wet. There is a number of cat and nine tails that are growing in that area.
Well, I was asked to bring the information forward, it's here, I'll save a couple copies for.
Visually, I'm not a good, I'm not good at this, so what is this road, is this Rollins?
That's Rollins.
Okay. That's going up to the bridge.
So I'm looking towards.
If you look to the right, if you kept going around to the right, that would be the overpass.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
So, I think your back would be the Peas.
I was gonna say, you must be on Peas Lane looking at it that way, okay.
Yeah.
I think maybe right at the corner of Peas and Rollins, that guy.
Yeah.
Probably sitting right by that fence and sort of looking.
Yeah.
Peas corner across it, but to me, it's not the best option, but I think we were charged with looking at all the available options. I know Bob, when he comes back, has another deal for building on wherever, but we've got to explore as well. And Charlie, you were going to look into.
I have to say, I haven't, but. Contracting.
Thank you. Contracting services.
Contracting police services?
Yes, with another community or other agency.
Oh, so, okay, so not just Rollins, but linking into either Dover's or whatever.
Not having a dedicated standalone police force. A lack of better terminology, so, but we're not done looking, obviously, so. And we want to express at least an interest in exploring that option too.
And only because we should, because as a due diligence thing, because if we're gonna spend a million plus on a building, let's kick it around and throw out all the options. I think it's been, I don't know, even talked about or mentioned before. And some of them make sense to do, you know, economy of scale and so forth, but other things don't make sense, but I think we should at least.
Is anybody in Stratford County contracting services?
No.
know, anybody in the state doing that?
I don't think so. I think everybody has their own police department. The only one that I know of really is Lebanon, Maine, who basically said, we're not gonna do it anymore, and they contract with York County Sheriff or the state police, and I think they use both, and where they've been back and forth with them.
So they don't have a PD, I'm sorry.
No, go ahead.
They don't have a PD at all?
Okay, so that's probably the closest local example here.
What about anything up in like COAS?
No, I don't think.
Or except for unincorporated place, but you know.
I think they all have, you know, chiefs of the various towns, but, you know, and it's, a lot of it's mutual aid, and they all work together up there, but more so like here than here.
Right.
Because everybody will pay.
Sure.
But I don't, there's nobody that I know of that comes to mind that has their own, you know, their contract. Are you aware of anybody else somewhere that contracts with another community for police services? The only one we thought of was Lebanon, Maine.
That's the one I'm aware of. I know, not municipal-wise, but I know private-wise, like Manchester Airport.
Yes. Right, because Londonderry's doing that.
Right, Londonderry's doing it, yeah.
It was the sheriff, it was Rockingham Sheriff.
It was at one time, yeah.
Those are the ones. But again, I think it's something we should just at least say we looked at.
What's the obligation with state police since a lot of our roads are state roads? Is, I mean, there's no obligation to have them go through the town? Okay, so Rollinsford is responsible even if it's a state road?
Because we have a full-time police department, the state police don't have to come over and patrol. Some of the IRS say, I feel the numbers for towns less than 3,000 people, because we haven't established a police department.
Okay.
If we didn't establish a police department, then they'd be required to provide those services. I'll give you an example, Madbury. Madbury doesn't have a full-time police department.
Right.
They have state police take call afternoons and evenings. Part-time chief and a bunch of part-time officers.
And whenever there's a somewhat even major case, they call state police.
Right, you know, having a former Madbury police officer working with currently, you know, she would tell you that. We've had a burglary, they don't do anything criminal in Madbury. They call state police and to handle it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they just do traffic in Highwire and then that may have changed, but at least when she was there, they didn't do any of that stuff.
And a typical shift at Troop A is how many people?
I'm sorry?
You may not know, a typical shift at Troop A. How many troopers do they have on the road?
I think it just depends on, you know, what their manual is. You know, like right now, most of the troopers are probably up in Weir's.
Weir's Beach, probably, right? Okay.
So,
well, that's something to think about, though. I mean,
but like every other agency, everyone right now is crying for police officers because everyone is short-handed right now. Because a number of factors, but one is, you know, folks aren't going to the law enforcement like they did 10, 15 years ago. So.
And the sheriff department doesn't have any jurisdiction in Rollinsford as well.
Well, they don't have a law enforcement division. They do civil process and transportation of prisoners.
Oh, okay.
There's no patrol.
There's no patrol.
They don't have it at all.
Yeah, Rockingham does.
Yeah, the other counties do, right? So I see,
yeah, some of them want to be pulled over.
Sheriff's stuff. I think.
But certainly, if they see you violate the law, they may pull you over.
Yeah.
But they're not out, their primary function isn't to be out there running radar and avoiding stop signs and motor vehicle accident prevention, things like that.
Okay.
There's civil process and transportation of prisoners.
Yeah. Rockingham may be the only one that I'm aware of that has a patrol function in the show.
Maybe it's in White Mountains.
I don't know.
For a while, Carroll
is.
Well, they were providing detective, you know, forensic services.
Okay.
For smaller towns. I don't know what basis, you know, whether they,
yeah.
But it was taxpayer funded at the county level, or right. Whether it was contracted in the municipal level. And I'm going back almost 20 years.
Yeah.
I don't know if Cheshire came that.
But you're going to continue to explore those options.
Yeah, and
so.
What I'll do is, while you were away, Chief, I think Bill put it better than I could, but it's like, we think we should consider all options as a part of due diligence. I'm not sure if fight with you or disrupt your legacy, but I think we will be asked about this, because $1 million is a big ticket for Rollinsburg. And even if the answer is, well, we asked, and the county sheriff said, not interested for one pound, and Dover said, no, not interested, and Summerswood said, no, not interested, but probably, I don't think we would go across state lines to certify.
I don't think we should. It would be very, in my opinion, very difficult, because you'd have to certify those guys in New Hampshire, and they would just be a...
But don't they come to mutual, is it the mutual aid agreement that protects the...
Under mutual aid, they come, because they're basically acting under...
Under our direction.
Your direction, okay.
Direction, or an officer's direction here, as we are over there.
Okay. So it's like the fire one, it's mutual aid.
But to have them come over, or have them police here, I think you would, you know, and quite honestly, they may not be familiar with the New Hampshire laws, that they would be called on to enforce once they cross the river.
And there are some interesting models, like I found one report, study done maybe by NACP, National Association of Chiefs of Police.
Chiefs of Police, yeah.
On it, and there are some interesting arrangements where a municipality has designated officers. These are Rollinsburg's officers picked by a Rollinsburg entity, but they're employed, trained, uniformed, and so forth by another entity and work in that town on a designated basis. I can still picture ways that you get into fights over, well, just how much of the time is the officer in town patrolling, and I think that's where the...
Well, I think you're right. People want to ask, why didn't you look at that? So we should have answers for them. So Bob has collected the surveys. How many did we get back?
Oh, quite a few, actually. Okay. As mentioned, we sent a survey to everyone on Silver Street from the intersection of Roberts Road all the way down to Pine Street, and everyone on Silver Lane. And three of them came back, became not in favor, and two of them had comments. This pile here were in favor and had comments, so I'm going to pass them around that way. And this pile here was just all marked in favor, but there weren't any comments at all in that pile there. And we had two come back as a little bit before.
So one person or one family, whoever, wrote, we feel that you stay in town, in the center of town, of course. One didn't say anything. And one said, we support the RPD. I believe that a town our size cannot justify the exercise, expend travel, sorry, millions on this capital investment. We need to be financially realistic. Let's do a quality investment in the existing space. Thank you for your consideration. So that's one of the things.
These are no responses. These are...
So the overwhelming was in favor of that location on Silver Street, or just in general moving you out of the basement?
So I think this was just
specific to
specific
Silver
Street,
Street,
right?
Yeah. For that neighborhood, just those folks.
Well, they would be the most directly impacted. So, are we okay if we talk to, well, looking at those, do we want to talk about something else, or do we want, I think, I want to be respectful, we're trying to read them, so. I know Bob has another estimate.
I'll just pass this on.
Okay, perfect.
Oh, went too far.
Went too far.
Went too far, there you go.
Okay, thank you. Just a print, that's, I haven't looked, I haven't looked at anyone, never, it was named that, the print. It's similar design though, of,
Yes.
The other one.
Okay, the first packet that says Norman Homes. Did you get, you have one?
Yes.
Everyone has. We actually have two packets, and they're both for the same building, and through Norman Homes, but Norman Homes is just doing the box units and modular, and they're estimating at this point $556,880. And then when the contractor comes in to button it up and put the rest of it together, if you look at page five, or the last page on the second packet that I gave you, that's the total project right there.
Including that?
Including this, yes.
Okay.
Right there. The second packet I gave you. That's the contractor's estimate based on taking the building itself from Norman Homes, and then adding the sewer, hook water ties, the garage, finish work. So.
And this is the Silver Street? For Silver Street?
Well, no, that's just for the building itself. Wherever it ends up going.
I was just looking at the well here, and we had water over there.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so
but the other two lots went in.
So three estimates, three different types of construction that we received, the source of drum, we're all in the same figure, $1 million to $1.2 million.
Will a modular allow expansion out?
Yes.
It will. Yes.
But the time to do it really is
it the time?
Is it when you're building initially.
Right, yeah. I agree with that. No. Structurally, anything. Have you made a decision which direction we're going?
Well, I think before you do that, you probably want to go and actually take a look at the ICF and the modular construction, because you're talking two entirely different types of construction.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And Farmington has the ICF?
The ICF.
So.
That one is much more secure, right? I mean,
yes.
It's much
sturdier building.
To be
much more energy efficient.
Yeah. And pretty close to the other price.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. A little more, but you're getting a lot more.
But you're getting a lot.
Sorry, yeah.
Right.
But it's good to see this estimate. So.
So I'm just wondering, maybe in July, we arrange a tour of Farmington Station.
Yeah.
The folks at New England Homes, so we could tour their facility anytime that we'd like. But that's in Claremont, New Hampshire. He did send me the name of two businesses, one's in Dover and one is in Exeter. It's a commercial building that is modular designed that was run by New England Homes. So I suppose we might be able to contact those two businesses to see if they might let us take a look at their building at some point.
Do you know which one is in Dover?
Yes. This is the new storage place on 6th Street.
Storage barn?
Storage barn, yes.
That's right where I work, right next to where you work.
Before you get to the traffic lights, it's just back, just a little bit on the right-hand side.
Something else there too. I'm not sure what they're building there.
Are they really?
Yeah.
So think at this point, I don't know how folks are feeling about this lot on Rollins, but I don't know how wet it is.
That's my concern, is
the fact that we already own.
Fact that we're on Silver Street.
Why buy something if you're a little piece of town property that you own?
I mean, it fits the bill, your design will fit on that lot. You didn't have a whole lot of objection to having it on Silver Street.
You have water in there.
You have water, you have water, you just don't have sewer, but you can have it on the other end, place either.
Right, I don't have sewer.
No, so you would have to have a separate.
You don't have water over there, is it?
You don't have water over there, right. So you'd have to drill a well. I mean, I think sewer is the way to go.
The only advantage I see here is it's more space, and if we wanted to do a municipal complex, it would be.
You could do it one level.
One level.
Yeah.
It would be easier to do, but I am concerned about water, because that's the problem we have here. So we want to go back into something where we're again dealing with water. I don't think so.
And previously, there was a gas station there, right? And you don't know what's underground either.
I do not.
Nobody does.
Do we know if the tanks were taken?
I don't know.
That's a long time ago.
That was a long time ago.
A long time ago, but again, back then, you didn't have rules that you have today.
So.
And I know back then, they had toilet in there, but they did not have a septic system, so.
Okay.
So we're going to find a big tank down there, I don't know.
Okay, well.
I think it's good to what we know versus what we don't know, and it fits the bill and we own it.
Okay, so I don't want to waste, I don't, if we're not interested in really exploring that lot further, I don't think we're going to waste a lot of time on that, so.
No, because it's another 100+ thousand to the bill.
Don't disagree. Okay.
Do you think there is any thought in talking to Mr. Webb? You know, if we're looking to consolidate and put everything in one building in the future, obviously Silver Street is not going to work. But the minds of the town is, all right, we need to do something, eventually you're going to deal with the fire station or whatever. It is to put everything in one central building. Would it be wise of us just to reach out to Mr. Wentworth to see if maybe he'd want to do a land swap for that property, that field that's along Greenview Drive and Main Street, that we all thought originally was the Turcotte Field, for some of the property itself in the back there?
So when we're talking, when you're saying, you're saying the lot that's open where the yellow grows is corn, is where you're thinking that we could put one there?
Correct.
Because that's what the yellow one was. Okay, so then what you're saying, doing a land swap, like where, behind Summers Roads?
Where the yellow plants corn also.
Oh, yeah, it's over there too? Oh, okay.
He runs it from the town, yeah.
Okay.
And it's going to be.
And that's Mr. Turcotte on.
Right.
Mr. Wentworth.
Oh, Mr. Wentworth.
The father.
Of the Wentworth Greenhills that area?
Yes, the owner's that.
And if people are interested in exploring them, it's like, we can reach out to them and see if there's any interest.
Mm-hmm.
If that's what.
But again, no water, no sewer?
Correct, no. So you have to drill a drill well, and you have to have a septic system there on Silver Street, so.
Yeah.
I hate to be slow thinking, but here I go. On the Silver Street property, there's no municipal exemption. If there are any kinds of environmental hazards that have to be remediated, and the town is going to have to do it if we build a town facility there, or do we think that they're somehow exempt?
I don't think I know the answer to that question, Charlie.
Okay.
But you're not going to put a foundation, right? You're just going to put a slab.
It'd be a bit above ground.
Sorry, I'm having trouble.
So you're not going to go.
It'd be 4 foot frost.
Try again in a moment.
Yeah, so you're not going to have to do.
You are going to have to.
Isn't there one there though? They have a toilet.
No, that's what.
Well, there is a septic system there now for the highway.
For the highway. He was talking about.
Oh, this is the highway department.
We're talking about the other lot.
Yeah, Silver Street lot.
Yeah, there's a septic system.
There's a septic there now.
Yeah, I don't know.
I think if you put it, you'd probably have to put a new septic system in it. I'm pretty positive you probably have to, because that one's quite old.
I think we would want to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, that one was probably designed for, less than half a dozen folks back in the 70s when it was put there. And And now you're talking another building for more individuals.
Yeah.
So, again, I apologize for my ignorance. So the Silver Street site is not where the gas station is?
No, we're talking about Portis Old Field.
This is where the gas station is.
Porter had a store there, right?
The store, yes.
Yeah, a store and gas station.
Store and gas station.
And that's when you agree it's good.
Yeah.
He's going to work with Terry Tanks.
That would be another reason we want to touch it.
Right. So we want to, we want to set up a tour with Farmington in July. Will you help facilitate that event?
It is a weeknight or maybe a Saturday or Sunday afternoon for an hour or two later for either of those?
Either is fine.
I think I personally prefer a late.
I do really well, so.
But either or, as far as I'm concerned.
I just know how Farmington be at nighttime, so they tend to be a little bit busy up there, so. I just hate to be there all of a sudden. There's a lot of rushing.
We don't want to be in the service.
We might be a little system in some way.
You can.
You might be a little system.
Mike, you take care of it.
As long as it's a daily evening time frame, it's fine with me. I mean, 7 would be too late, at 6 would be fine.
I mean, it wouldn't take more than an hour.
Yeah.
And we could arrange it so the folks that actually built the building will be there, and they can explain their process and why they went this way, and what the benefits are.
Where is it in Farmington? Is it on 11 or is it off?
You go up 11, and what is that, 152?
I think so. You have the traffic light, take the right, as you head into downtown Farmington, you get the golf course on the right. Well, before you get to the golf course, on the left hand side.
Okay, so it's not where the old fire station?
No.
It's before that.
Before that, okay, so it's in that area?
Yeah, before you get into town.
Into, okay.
We just asked you not to.
Yeah, the old fire station.
Obviously, they can't do anything on Monday night.
Yeah.
Change at this table, so, several hours.
Usually nights are a little.
I think I'm already that second weekend, so.
Is this Thursday still going to happen, right?
It is, generally, yeah.
Thursday, generally?
Thursday.
But if they couldn't do it on any other day, then the 11th is just definitely going to be. We're going to have a very lengthy planning.
My best night.
The 11th is out for me, but I could do 18 or 25.
Okay.
Because the 4th is the 4th.
I'll try to shoot for the 18th.
I'm sorry, 18th is Tuesday. So then we want to.
You want to do that, or you want to do the?
20th.
Or 27th.
27th is not good for me, but you need to go. Is the 13th okay for you?
13th, I'll be gone.
I'll be gone, okay.
I've seen it before, so, you know, I've been through the building before, so better for everybody to have 13.
It'd be nice to see the, that building style after the police station too, so.
Awesome.
Before I ask any of our audience any questions?
This is the style that's the more secure, more energy efficient one. This is what we're going to call it. So I'm not interested in going to Claremont, but if someone else wants to take the ride to go see that.
Yeah.
Well, you can certainly YouTube and just type in modular building, and there's all kinds of videos on there on how these modular buildings put these buildings together inside of their large factories. So if you want to see what the process is and how it works.
But you said that one on Sixth Street is one of the modulars?
Right. The one on Sixth Street is a New England Homes modular building.
I'm not concerned with seeing how they build it, the one actually built.
Yeah.
If we could.
There and.
Take a trip over to Dover even.
Rockingham Dental in Exeter, New Hampshire is also one of their buildings according to the folks at New England. So.
What was the storage place?
It's called the Storage Barn, or the Storage Barn.
Oh, right.
385 Sixth Street.
It's a solar power too.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Anything else we want to talk about before I ask our audience if they want to say anything?
So, just one more clarification is, when, or are we not the deciding factor of is it going to contain town administration as well as police, or not?
If we think it's prudent to make that recommendation, we'll stop for it, we should. If we don't believe it's prudent, we should. I mean, what we were looking for, police basement solutions. That's really the crux of forming this group. But if we think it makes more sense to have a dual conversation, we can present that to the board. And the board can say, well, it's just not feasible, it's not practical, or yes, we're intrigued by your ideas and we'll explore it further. So we're just making recommendations one way or another. So.
Having said that, I wonder if it's the advantageous for us to reach out to a Chinburg type person and say, is there any interest from you in this type of building? Because I know when we did the remodel, you had an interest in this building.
I just think that
in purchasing this building?
I just think if we're going to do it, we should do it at the same time, not do it 5 years later. You know what I mean? I mean, that's if that's a desire, we should do it at the time of having it. And I think is we need to put the police out of the city.
Right.
I agree with you 100%.
My fear is that if we grow this thing too big, are we going to not achieve the goal of getting the police out of the basement?
Real concern.
So,
that is a concern.
You know, that's.
But at the same time, you know, I hear the little scuttlebutt that says, you know, if the police move, now you're spending a lot of, you're still spending almost the same amount of money to maintain the building for a couple of hours a day for a couple staff members. So is it really worth it? So that's why I'm asking. Maybe this is the time we reach out to a Chinburg type of person and say, is there an inch? Do you have interest in this building? If so,
well,
and just kind of wrap it all up at once, because you can certainly add this to the tax roll in town.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that certainly helps on the other end.
Mm-hmm.
While we're at it, why don't we, ICS?
ICF?
Yeah, did the Farmington building, and they did a sort of a plan for us, too, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, so we put a second floor on it and give us an update, and, you know, let's.
Well, this one, I don't want to ask them to do too much, because everything they've done right now is for free.
Free.
And I don't want to ask them
to work.
Well, okay. Yeah. I mean, I can certainly reach out and say, you know, are you willing to maybe throw an elevator in there someplace? Because you have to have an elevator.
Because you'll have to have
an elevator. And put a second floor on X amount of square foot for town officers, town offices, because you don't need a second large conference room, because we have the large one downstairs.
Yep.
So maybe a smaller one, like planning things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And say, you know, how much you think it would be per square foot, whatever the case might be. I don't draw up a plan at this point, but what do you think it'd be square foot wise? Give us a perspective.
I think that's a good idea, asking what the price square foot would be. I'm not asking that for a plan. Personally, I'm not in favor of mothballing this building, but I just wonder what it's like for us. But it's important to present all options.
Yeah.
It's very important. So.
I mean, but this building can be used by a lot of different people other than just the employees of the, you know, having meetings and stuff, and you know, so it's not like it's not going to still be used for those things, you know. So
there's still plenty of uses. So anything else you want to talk about though tonight? We have a number of guests. If anyone wants to ask questions or add comments, you're more than welcome to.
Jim Jalbert, 46 Fincham Road, Reynolds from New Hampshire. I obviously think that there's a problem downstairs and something ought to be done. I would caution this committee to really, unfortunately, you're tasked with the police department, but there's a far bigger issue, and that is, you know, what's really going to happen to this building, and do you really need to take a long view in terms of developing a municipal facility? And I don't think you can want to cookie cutter this thing. So you don't want to go build a modular style building and then try to add to it. I think that is just real misuse of funds. I don't have any idea what the square footage of the proposed building is, but I've heard $1.2 million, and I know how much square footage you got downstairs. That's a whole lot of money per square foot. The other thing I would respectfully suggest is that whatever lot you choose, you really want to think about the future. So I, you know, Porter's lot, I would go to DES and see if they did remediation. That would tell you right away whether or not the thing's clean or not. My guess is when the tanks, pumps came out of there and the tank came out of there, they did remediation on the lot. You know, there's a fund set up just for that purpose. The state goes around and cleans it up, much like they did with Kenny Bolduc's property years ago. I think that, you know, Rollinsford is sort of a crossroads. We've got a school that we really don't know what the future is going to be. We'd all like to think that the grade school will hang on forever, but the truth of the matter is changing demographics and school roles declining. I know we've sort of leveled off here a little bit, but New Hampshire still losing a whole lot of kids. And so, you know, that whole situation may change. You know? And so, does a future municipal facility require some larger meeting space? You know, does it require putting the planning board and all the other boards there? I don't think you should look at selling this as, I think you should look at selling this as part of the overall equation in the end, but you shouldn't like go to Schimberg today and say, hey, you want to do a deal so we can go do this. I think you have to make your decision because you need to make your decision to build a new station. And I think it should be centrally located. I don't know how big Porter's lot is, and I never thought of it for that, but it actually is a decent sized lot. Drilling a well is not a big deal. Putting a septic system in for a municipal building is done all over rural America. It's not a big deal. Putting the tanks in for the sprinklers because of building requirements is an added expense, but you can still do it. And so I support the chief in this committee's efforts and the town's efforts to figure out how to fix the problem. I only ask that you look at the big picture, because you could go spend $1.2 million and then 3 years from now say, oh my God, we should have built a municipal center. And you know, it may be worth, and I know how tough it is to get things for the budget, but it may be worth getting $5,000 to $10,000 in the next cycle to even do a rendering of what it could be. You know, some space planning, some proper space planning, so you know what your needs are for now and into the future. Because I can tell you, you could waste a whole lot of money doing this in little pieces. It's going to cost you a lot more money. The economy is the scale of building a building which encompasses all your needs. You know, your square footage price drops, especially when you go upstairs. So. But I support it. Charlie, I know you're saying, Jim, why aren't you on this committee? Because if I got another committee, that woman right there would shoot me. So that's why I'm not in this committee.
Might be justified, I don't know.
The shooting, it is justified, we know that. So that's all I wanted to say, and thanks for your hard work.
Appreciate your input.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
See you guys.
Anyone else? All right, so we will meet again in July. We will find out the data from the Cheetos, because he's going to arrange it with Farmington.
I will try to get it.
But I do appreciate everyone's time.
The 30th of the 20th.
It seems like you didn't.
So what is the goal? I'm sorry. What is the goal for a presentation to somebody about what this committee is recommending? What is that, the time frame for that?
The original time frame was a month,
which
wasn't realistic.
Yeah.
And we set that time, that goal, because we wanted to stay on top of it.
Mm-hmm.
We mentioned that at the select board meeting. They said, okay, we understand that you're not going to make, the chief mentioned, he's like, there's no way we're going to make it in a month. And they recognize that. They just don't want you to lose sight of the ultimate goal of presenting something. To me, doing the tour in July would be very important, so we can see what an ICF building actually looks like. As I looked at the plans, and I can visualize it, but I'd rather see it in person. looking at, just quickly looking at this estimate, I'm not sure module is the way to go, but I still think we should look at, and getting in cyber these facilities might be helpful. I don't want to push us off, keep pushing it off and pushing it off, but at least another 2 or 3 months, I think, to be honest with you. I don't think that this is...
I mean, it's not something we want to rush into.
Right.
But again, I don't want them down there another 5 years. I mean,
and
be all honest, I mean, so I totally appreciate what he was saying, I do, about municipalities and making sure you have enough. In Silver Street, there isn't any expandability.
Mm-hmm.
It is, it's going to have to go up, not out.
Correct.
So, however, you know, I mean, I don't know if we can have the answer soon.
I mean, at Silver Street, we could do, it looks like police and town. We could get that done. Fire, no way.
Correct.
And if we want to do the big picture, police, fire, and town, we need something like that.
Quarters
field to do it.
That's what they're talking about, is police, fire, and town? Are they talking about a complete town administrator?
I don't think, I think that's just what, you know, that the fire department building is going to need work, is it not? And that's what complicates it for me, because, you know, it's the old saying, you came to drain the swamp, but, you know, when you're up to your, we'll say neck in alligators, it's hard to remember what you're trying to do, because
yeah.
You're trying to swat the alligators away. And that's kind of where I, you know, there's so many needs. But I think Jim was right, you know, to take the big picture look. And, you know, that's, does anybody know the sense of the town, you know, people? Are they looking for the big picture solution for it all? Or are we looking for,
I don't think that will ever sell, I'll be totally honest with you. It will be enormous price tag. The thing is, the fire station, they're definitely landlocked, so they can't grow any more than what they are doing.
Unless
what they
go into the ball field, if they could get that
into
property
the,
from the cemetery.
Right, okay. So, you know, I'm not sure how much more they have to grow. And if they wanted to, they could go up to have a training facility or something. But to sell a ticket of Fall 3, I don't think that's ever going to happen. It's going to be too big.
The major concern that we keep hearing is taking care of the problem downstairs, the police station.
Yeah.
There are folks that are very unhappy about putting any money at all into this building for anything. Routine maintenance at times. So, and there are those that want to save the building. So, I mean, it runs the gamut in between. Don't do a thing to this white elephant to save this beautiful historic building, right? And then everything in between.
Mm-hmm.
What we heard loud and clear, I think, and that's why we wanted to form this committee at town meeting and afterwards, and leading up to town meeting, was that we need to do something about the police downstairs. We all recognize it anyway, so here we are. Originally, I thought police and fire, a safety complex, but and I wanted to see it added on next door to the existing fire department.
Well, ideally that would have worked.
For other reasons, so.
Because you can utilize dispatching services and all of
that
kind of stuff.
Right, I mean, that would have been
ideal
personally,
yeah.
To me anyways, but it's just not going to work, so.
I guess that being the case, then, it seems that, you know, if we're going to move the police out, I'd kind of like to see town go with it, because it's here, it makes sense to do that. Then, you know, we deal with fire at a later date. You know, down the road, either you know, expand, rehab that facility there, you know, and then we decide what we're going to do with this place.
Here's the one truth, as I see it. No matter what we present, ultimately, there are going to be people that think it's fabulous, and there are going to be people that think we're the dumbest people in town,
of course.
So, and everything in between, right? So, I don't want to get too hung up on that, but right, we definitely want to fasten our seatbelts. But I think ultimately we're going to just have to come up with one plan, present to the select board, and then the select board will then hash it out there, and we'll have a public hearing.
Yeah.
And we will hear from the public that they say this is stupid, pardon me, but just people
people will tell us, they're not shy.
Mm-hmm.
We'll go back to the drawing board. If they think, oh, this is a great idea, and we'll embrace it, and we'll move forward, but they will tell us, you know, you should have been on safety conference. Or you should have, why are you moving the town hall? I mean, why are you including the town hall? I mean, they will tell us for sure, so.
The thing is, again, you will lose an opportunity, like you did on Silver Street.
Right.
If we wait long time to make our decisions, mm-hmm. you know, and yeah. if the decision is to have a complete complex and people support it in town, then that is probably one of the only places that you can do it, except maybe Wentworth Hill.
Forest Field.
You know, yeah. If they're willing to even depart it, mm-hmm. to, you know, with it. But again, timing is just. Mm-hmm. And you don't want to rush it because you want to make sure it's the right thing and then it gets passed. But
I mean, I can certainly gauge the opinion of the rest of the select board as to whether or not they have an appetite to explore mm-hmm. Multiple options or whether they just want standalone fire police department. Mm-hmm. They pretty much have taken a hands-off approach and wanted us to.
Yeah.
You know what?
Those guys.
We'll take it back to them for a moment and then we'll see. Because you're right, if we wait too long, we will lose the opportunity.
Well, opportunities just seem to go away.
Which, again, I think if we can get a square foot figure from Mr. Groen or whoever it is, you know, and we can throw that in and say, look, you know, this is what it's going to be for the police department, one floor. If we go up a second floor, here's what we're looking at, and we can include town with it. And then, you know, then that gives us options for this building, either abandon it, whatever we're going to do with it, sell it, whatever.
The work that I know of, and I don't spend nearly, I will say any time really, maybe once a month to have pancakes at the fire station.
Mm-hmm.
Besides the roof, it may be a new septic system.
Mm-hmm.
What else?
Well, you know, this, I mean, I don't think, and this is just me talking personally, but I don't think it really has a whole lot of stuff. I mean, it just needs updating.
Right.
So, you know, probably, if I'm throwing something out, it's like 500,000 could get it to where it needed to be.
Right.
I don't think they need to have another bay because you're making them or trading in that fire truck so they're going to get the fire truck,
right.
So they're not gaining any equipment.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, it just needs updating.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the boiler room needs updating. Their, you know, maybe their kitchen needs to have some updating.
Right.
Their bathroom needs some updating.
Right.
Mark may disagree with me
right.
totally,
right, right,
but
right.
I just, you know, what I experienced when Harry was chief is, the roof, you know, they don't have a really big training room. You know,
right.
So maybe kind of update that a little bit, you know. But
okay.
To say that they need a brand new station, I don't know.
Right. The other reality, I mean, we live in a community that hasn't grown as quickly as some of the communities around us.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. A whole host of reasons for that. But, and I don't see us exploding. But then again, there are a number of very large tracts of land that are privately held that
mm-hmm.
could be developed.
Wow,
and,
that's
and,
true.
And so, again, yeah, population could grow quite a bit. But even if it did, do we need another fire truck? Do we need more space? I mean, I don't know.
Yeah, but I
think that truck?
Their concern is give me the equipment to do my job
right.
and make it good equipment.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I think bottom line is life safety.
Right, of course.
Air packs and trucks to get into the scene, and that's
right.
what's the most important for them, mm-hmm. I would think. Yeah, there's opportunities to train there, but you know if you needed a bigger conference room, they could
right.
come down here. But you know that there's
they
options.
Could,
they could go to the grade school. There's you know in the
and
gym,
they go to other
know.
Departments too.
And they
that's
go to
Mark
other
has said
departments.
They, no,
exactly.
They,
you know, but
in fact, they've brought other departments in to do training at our station.
Yeah,
so I mean,
yeah.
it's done. I mean, you know, they pull the trucks out and
yeah, they
got
the bays. Yeah,
they've
exactly.
got the bay, both bays, right? So.
Just
yeah, I don't want to lose sight of really why we were formed, was really to deal with the men and women that are all for the police department in the deplorable conditions they're working in right now.
Right.
And so.
And they're in it every single day. Not that some aren't at the station in and out.
Yeah,
all day.
Yeah,
they're
yeah.
In
yeah
there
they,
all
One caution on the go-large approach. I attended a number of meetings as the school board was contemplating how to approach the expansion or not of the school building. And, you know, that's another big ticket, and the demographic projections for this town, for this state, for this region are not, right now, not looking particularly good, which I think makes it a little hard if you want to take a strict dollars and cents point of view of, like, what are the land values going to be like here in 15 years, and what is the average age of our taxpayer in 15 years? Boy, the appetite to take on school plus fire plus police plus municipal infrastructure needs all at once, it's a tough sell.
It's not affordable.
It's a tough sell.
Yeah.
But I also agree that the working conditions of the police department need to be addressed.
And we have been downstairs in our office, so. With apologies to the nice people, that one person that wrote that on their form, I don't think that's a realistic option, so.
As we prepare for a public meeting, we should probably be ready to address that option. We should probably talk about the combined needs of municipal fire and police. At least to the to reflect the conversations we had about, we thought about it.
Mm-hmm.
Here's why we decided not to go further with it.
It has nothing to say that we can't present three plans to the select board. Yeah. Here's the plan for the standalone police department. Here's your plan for police and fire, and here's all three.
Mm-hmm.
Go have your public hearing.
Mm-hmm.
You take the lashes. We've done the homework for you.
We're going to skip that.
Yeah. I mean,
no, it's true. And then when they see the difference between a million or 3 million or
7 or whatever,
7 million,
I mean,
you know where they're going to go.
Yeah.
Well, I think I believe that. I do too. But
mm-hmm.
I mean, glad you had the meeting.
Well, no, it's true. But
Mike has been a good advocate over the years for avoiding cost isn't always the best economic strategy in
right.
the long run.
Very
That's
true.
Why we're in that position right now.
A lot of deferred maintenance in this building,
right.
And it comes catches up with you eventually. So,
it does.
Yeah. So I mean, it's possible that when you explain it to taxpayers,
mm-hmm.
they'll go, "Yeah, yeah." I mean, I guess particularly if we could show that we would somehow save costs or save. And I understand Jim's point about not getting all hot with Chinberg, but. I'm sure that those who want to save the building don't want to see this place fall apart.
Right.
And I would, just from a straight politics and community standpoint, I think that's, I'll try to stay on board with whatever you want to do, but I know personally that would cause a lot of heartache on Slide Road. And there's some strong voices on Slide Road, I might remind you. So I think at least having a strategy for what's the exit plan. If we're taking municipal out of here, what
mm-hmm.
do we think somebody would pay for it? What do we think the use would be?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know who could. Mike Garrity might be somebody that we could call just to say, hey, is anybody buying a building like this? What do they use it for? How do you value it? Because
mm-hmm.
this is not on the rolls. So
Have you looked on me to see if there's any grant or matching grants like with FEMA or anything like that?
For the building itself, no.
Is that even something that has happened, do you know?
No. There's no money out there for the building itself. However,
okay.
you want to put in a security system for an EOC, you want to put a generator,
okay.
things like that, and
okay.
there are matching grants.
Okay.
Or for the building itself, there's actually
no
money out there
no
whatsoever.
Money.
Correct.
Okay. All right. Well. But the
we have a very diligent police chief in our community that's always looking for grants. So,
unless they just awarded us,
if it's out there, he will be looking
dollars.
For it. I get short of that.
New cruiser laptops, so we're going to be
good
paperwork that looks like the ones on Monday design. So,
nice.
Yeah. But just throw some numbers. I did some research, and from 1999 to 2013, the town, for this renovation, they spent $50,000 per year for the bond principal and then interest on top of that. So it started out at, I guess, 38,000 in interest the first year, and it worked down, anyway. So I took $1 million and I divided it by 20 years. That's $50,000 per year bond without the interest. 25-year bond, that's $40,000 per year. Again, no interest. You did it for 30 years, that's, you know, $33,333.33. Type of thing. So just some numbers. So there is some precedent. The town did at one point spend, I think for the first year, it was like almost $90,000 for the renovation project. And then at the year, it just went down and down and down. So,
it
might be doable. We try to keep the numbers about the same as we did back in 1999.
Yeah.
And but that's a good point.
But at that point, I think the interest rates were higher back then than they are right now, too. So there might be some type of a savings there, just for the interest rates.
The bonds that we floated, I don't remember what the rates were,
2.7
is what we ended up getting. So
and then there was a projects that
for the transfer station and the fire truck.
Just under it.
So,
and, you know, now that the police officers are, you know, we're working details outside the community, I think the town netted about $25,000 last year after all expenses were paid. So,
netted on what?
About $25,000.
On what? I'm sorry.
On police details.
Okay.
So, in a way, we could say, you know, police are kind of contributing towards the towards the mortgage. You know, we're going to give you 1/3 by having the officers, you know, bust their humps all year long, wear details.
By your guns.
But certainly, you know, that does help. You know,
sure.
That goes into the equation, and hopefully it's another plus.
Mm-hmm.
Some sort of, so.
More to think about.
Yeah.
I think the multiple approach is a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Having the board more than one option.
More than one option, but I guess I'm leaning more toward leaving fire out of it now. If it's, I mean, is that going to muddle the issue for the police department? And if it's not, you know, it'd be great to do. Don't get me wrong. I'd love to see a municipal complex.
It needs to be updated, yeah.
But is it going to really push us away from our goal of getting the police department out of the basement?
Mm-hmm.
I would say yes, but
yeah,
only one person. So.
Mm-hmm.
I think our two options we really want to look at is standalone and police in town.
And
yes, I agree.
Administration. And that can be on
that's not necessarily my personal preference, but I think that's what.
No, that would be mine as well, because I think, again, I'd love to see the whole shebang in one place, but I just, you know, it's going to have
I don't think.
And
how's that going over well? So.
What you're saying, I think, is it's we haven't reached a crisis point at the fire department yet.
I don't think so, unless something's happened since, you know, but Dave's on it, and he would have been squawking at me if there wasn't.
I mentioned something to you.
Oh, sure. Yeah, you know. But, you know, structurally, I think it's fine. You just need some cosmetic work. You know.
Well, maybe more than cosmetic, but
well,
if we do a fairly substantial, but less than the whole building, but upgrades and put the maintenance into it that maybe it should have been having over the years.
Right.
Maybe that will address those issues.
Exactly. Yeah.
No matter what we say or do, we can walk.
Yeah.
For some folks, it won't be answered. That is true.
Can't please everybody.
No. Okay, so the next meeting is going to be the field trip.
July, probably the third week of July, hopefully.
Okay. You sent something around?
Yeah, oh, definitely.
Okay.
Definitely.
I'll send it to you when you pass on.
I'll have
it.
You need to be closer, right?
Yeah, all right.
I will try, I'll be away next week, but I will try to reach Tony and Dave and just say, who would we talk to talk about contracting? And I assume Sheriff DuBois, if you don't, you're not going to. County Sheriff is not going to be interested in creating a patrol division for a single contract.
I would. I mean, I would, if we're gonna do the due diligence, yeah, I would contract the sheriff.
Because a lot of people, someone will say, why didn't you ask the sheriff's department?
Yeah.
There is a pretty good facility over here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, they use, well, their lockup is the jail.
Gonna be a lot of extra room once the new women's prison is finally built too.
Where's that from?
Down the street from men's prison.
They'll just bring more federal prisoners in.
Right. But they gotta hire.
Well, you might have to hire more folks.
DOC hasn't hired anybody to staff that new women's prison. I talked to a couple of their guys.
How much, well, the new women's prison has been delayed again. I just sat through the budget conference committee. They postponed the nurses, the cooks, the janitors, all of them for another year and a half.
I think, one of the guys told me they need 37 people to staff the Goffstown.
Governed by a lawsuit or something.
The new one, they're gonna need 75, and they, and that may even be per shift, right? I'm not sure. But they haven't made any arrangements to start bringing these new people.
They've got a 6.8, I don't know how they got a 0.8 of a person, but. Nurses. I know, I get that, but, so 6.8 nurses for the prison in Goffstown. That they rent from Hillsborough County, which I didn't realize, but anyways.